My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, it is wonderful to be here with all of you to pray this afternoon in celebration of Holy Mass.
Una gran alegría estar con todos ustedes esta tarde para la celebración de la Santa Misa, para rezar juntos por los inmigrantes. As we know, this has been a week with tension and high emotions here in our city and in cities across the country. Our hearts go out to all the families who suffer as a consequence of violence. So today we want to keep praying for one another, for our city, for our country. We want to ask God for more patience, for more understanding, for real peace. Pedimos a Dios nuestro Señor que nos ayude a ser mensajeros de paz y de reconciliación. En estos momentos en los que nuestro país está experimentando dolor por la violencia, que nos conceda la fortaleza de saber perdonar y nos haga instrumentos de verdad, de paz y de amor. Also, I know that many of you are deeply involved in the political process to bring justice to our immigration system. And I want to say thank you to each one of you for everything you are doing for the least of our brothers and sisters. But there is a time for politics and a time for prayer. Prayer should always come first, before our political action. Because we always want to make sure that we are trying to do God's will and not our own will. And that's why we are here this afternoon. Esta misa es un momento especial de oración, un tiempo para ponernos en la presencia de Dios y abrirle nuestros corazones, pidiendo su misericordia y su amor. Un momento de reflexionar sobre nuestras vidas y nuestro país, a la luz de la palabra de Dios que acabamos de escuchar. The readings today from Sacred Scripture remind us that God comes to us in the person of the stranger, in the person of the immigrant. That's the constant teaching of the Bible, from beginning to end. The first reading we heard today was from the Bible's first book, the book of Genesis. We see the noble father of Judaism, Abraham, who is also our father in Christ. Abraham does not know that these three visitors who come to his tent are from God. But he does know that every person is made in the image and likeness of God. Abraham, en la primera lectura, recibe a los extranjeros con su corazón abierto. No sabía que venían de parte de Dios. Les habla de buena manera. Les ofrece un lugar para descansar. Les lleva agua para que se limpien los pies del polvo del camino. Su esposa Sara cocina el mejor de los alimentos para ellos. My brothers and sisters, for Judaism, hospitality and care for the stranger are a sacred duty. And the same thing is true for Christianity. In the letters of the apostles, we read, "Do not neglect hospitality, for to it some have unknowingly entertained angels." We are a people who know the truth, that we are all God's children, that our lives are sacred and special to God. Everyone. We do not get our dignity from having the proper documents or the right paperwork. Our human dignity comes from God. This is why this country is unique. Because the missionaries and statesmen who founded this country believed what Abraham believed and what Jesus taught, that all men and women are created by God with equal dignity, rights, and freedom. Nuestro país siempre ha sido una nación de inmigrantes, un faro de esperanza, una luz que brilla en la oscuridad, una puerta dorada que se abre a los que buscan una mejor vida para sus familias. Y como todos sabemos, nuestra dignidad no viene de si tenemos unos papeles u otros, o si no los tenemos, sino de que somos cada uno de nosotros hijos de Dios, creados a la imagen y semejanza de Dios. And that's exactly what we are working for in our politics. And that's what we are praying for today. We pray today for courage to keep working for what is right and what is true. And what is right and is true, as I have said other times, is that immigration is not about statistics. We are talking about souls, not statistics. We are talking about real people, men and women, parents and children, older people and younger people. We are talking about fathers who, without warning, won't be coming home for dinner tonight, who may not see their families again for a long time. We are talking about women suddenly left as single mothers to raise their children in poverty. So my brothers and sisters, let us pray for the courage that each one of us be able to help our neighbors remember that America has always made room for people from many cultures, speaking different languages, with different beliefs, customs, and traditions. What we see clearly in our archdiocese, with the cultural diversity, beautiful cultural diversity that we have in the church, in the local church of Los Angeles. That is what is right and is true. In the passage of the gospel today, we heard Jesus call out, "Martha, Martha." And my brothers and sisters, today Jesus is calling each one of us again personally by our names. He's asking each of us to look into our hearts. When we think about this beautiful passage of the gospel of Martha and Mary, cuando pensamos en este pasaje del Evangelio de Marta y María que conocemos bien, nos suena todo familiar, porque así es la vida en cualquier familia. Marta está trabajando con gran entusiasmo y María, en cambio, está simplemente contemplando a nuestro Señor. Hasta que Marta no le parece muy bien y entonces va con Jesús y se queja. ¿No te importa que yo tenga que hacer todo y mi hermana no me ayude? Sounds familiar, ¿eh? Suena familiar lo que pasa en nuestras casas a veces, ¿no? Es un pasaje bello en el que vemos la conversación entre Jesús, Marta y María. Y Jesús le habla personalmente a Marta. Hoy nos habla a cada uno de nosotros. So when we think about these beautiful passages of the gospel, we become more aware of Jesus' humanity. And especially that he was always a stranger. He came into this world as a child in the womb. And there was no room for him at the inn. When he was an infant, his family, his mother Mary and Joseph, her husband, they were driven into exile by political violence. They had to emigrate. So they live as immigrants and refugees in Egypt. So throughout his whole ministry, Jesus never had a home. He had no place to lay his head. Mis queridos hermanos y hermanas, Jesús se hizo extranjero por nosotros, para enseñarnos cómo amar a nuestro prójimo. Nos enseñó a encontrarlo a Él, a encontrar a Dios en los pobres, en los prisioneros, en los inmigrantes, porque ellos son los más débiles de la sociedad, porque son los que más necesitan de nuestra protección y de nuestro cuidado. And Jesus said that God will judge us by our love for Him in the least of our brothers and sisters. So immigration is not only a matter of politics. It's a matter of our relationship with God and our relationship with one another. Let's especially pray today that God will change our hearts and change the hearts of our neighbors and our leaders. We especially pray for our elected officials, that they have the courage to address the needs of our immigrants with a comprehensive immigration reform bill as soon as possible. Now is the time for immigration reform. Let us pray for that. Pedimos hoy que Dios nuestro Señor nos dé a todos un nuevo compromiso de caridad y de hospitalidad. Un nuevo convencimiento de nuestra obligación de luchar en contra de la injusticia y de la crueldad, para hacer que nuestro país sea una sociedad en la que nadie es un extraño a los ojos de Dios. In this beautiful cathedral, dedicated to Our Lady of the Angels, let us ask our Blessed Mother Mary to watch over the immigrants in our midst. May God's holy angels accompany them, all of us, always, on our journey to justice, peace, truth, and love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.